So I think we're finally back online, guys. Sorry we lost you all out there for a little while. But we're up in the shallowest of the transects now. We're running along at 50 metres. As you can see, there's a lot of sand up here. And we're all a little bit surprised about that, actually. We were hoping that we'd start to see lots of really nice hard corals or sclerotinian corals. But no, just lots of sand and the odd soft coral. Seen a couple of sea cucumbers, but yeah. I'm sure Nerida's keeping her eyes open for a baler shell.
Sure am.
Must be hard to read the comments as well. So, we on it, aren't
we?
It's just a small writer.
Yes, I.
Just look at my headphones.
End of the transect, are we, guys?
60 metres away. 60 metres
to go.
Yeah,
I think we might go back down to the deep stuff, but it was interesting. Nothing against sand. But it's not that interesting. So Ian Parnham from Curtin Uni's just come into Mission Control here, and I think he's got a little message for some friends at home.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't be a good dad if I wasn't able to say hello to my family, particularly my family, particularly my two boys, Owen and Luke. I hope you're watching and enjoying the show. It's a real fascinating voyage being on here with such great equipment, and yeah, I'm interested to see what we can find.
Ian, do you want to tell us a bit about what your role here is on board Falkor?
Thanks, Karen. Yes, I'm here from Curtin University. I'm at the Centre for Marine Science and Technology. We specialise in underwater acoustics, multi-beam surveying, cameras along to help maybe try a bit of photogrammetry for some high-level detail 3D models.
Sorry, Ian, you were saying? we all got distracted by the sea cucumber.
That's understandable. Who wouldn't get distracted by a sea cucumber? fascinating creatures. So my area of interest and research is in various ways to image and visualize the seafloor and the marine environment. So I'll be helping with produce maps of the seafloor, and also have a look if we can image the water column. And like I said, we've got some cameras and we might try mosaicing some of the images together. And what have we just gone past there?
Really?
Isn't as interesting as the cucumber, but it was something. Ah, yeah. We've got to show them some love as well, I guess.
Where's the ejector button?
Awesome. He told me not to touch
it. I see there's a question about what's the gravel made of. I'm going to guess a lot of this is carbonate material, is it? That is just eroded off the reef?
Yeah, I guess it's carbonate. Lots of skeletons of corals and other animals and broken down.
And I think you've kind of answered Jason's question as well there by saying where did this rubble came from? Just the erosion processes really, you know, wearing away.
And yes, as Jason in Michigan says, possibly halimeda contributes to that, which is a coralline algae. It's a calcareous skeleton as well.
I guess one of the things is the more of this material you're going to find less... so before we had more exposed kind of harder substrate where you had, so you had more things being able to grip on, whereas here we've now got more of a layer of sediment, so I guess we're expecting less. Is that right or wrong?
I was expecting this to be more consolidated in shallow water and with more corals, and so that's the great thing about science, is it never does what you think it should, and we're always getting challenged by things that we might assume. So but yeah, further down deep, as the multi-beam data showed us, it was a lot steeper, and so we had less sand build up and we had more sort of hard substrate available for things to grow on. So we're going to head back down into the deep dark depths of 100 metres very soon, once we get to the end of this transect,
which is just about,
and spend a bit of time having a little bit of a closer look at some of those critters down there now that we've done the transect work, which we had to kind of keep going at a constant speed and a constant distance from the seafloor for the transect data, but now we're going to be free to do a little bit more adventuring and looking around.
So I better go back to the seafloor mapping part of the boat.
Thanks, Ian.
And I'll do this, and yeah, if Owen and Luke are listening, it's a hi from Daddy, and I better go back and do some work. Thanks.
How deep do you want to go?
In transit.
Just start working our way down.
Yeah, if we can head back down now to the start of that, around about the start of the 100 meter transect. So basically directly downhill now. We saw some interesting things in the sort of, as we were transiting between the 150 to the 100 meter transect, there was some interesting things there that we'd like to now go back and have a look at.
So I think we're going to take a blue water trip, people, while we reorganise the ROV and the ship, so get prepared for a different experience for the next few minutes.
with us about 10 meters there.
Yeah, right.
Here for the ship to catch up.
Yeah.
So as we make our way down back to the deeper parts where we were before, we're just sort of slowly following the ship. We need to make sure that the kind of the umbilical cord that connects the ROV to the ship remains sort of safe and unjangled. So we're just sort of slowly following behind and waiting every now and then for the ship to get ahead, but still making our way back down to that start of the 100 meter transect again. So in this area you see sponges, where you're just going past a crinoid there that's sitting on the sand. It's a bit unusual. Most crinoids tend to cling on to other organisms, but there are some species that can anchor themselves into sand. So beautiful. Never thought I'd say that a sea cucumber was beautiful, but he's quite beautiful.
Majestic cucumber. See how majestic it is.
There we go. Imagine a little boop on the nose. Face. We're not actually going to touch him. But
it's only a face of mama cucumber.
No. It's beautiful.
Nice trees behind him, rocks on the beach, drinking a pina colada.
Yeah. So you can see we're here at about 80 meters and already there's a lot more rubble and a lot more life than there was up in that shallower part. So again, we're just sort of taking in the sights as we wait for the ship to move on. This beautiful, gorgeous anemone, we're probably not going to boop it because it won't take very well, so we might just admire and move on. Okay, so amongst the requests for booping, this is actually a time when we may boop. We're interested in some of the parasites that occur on echinoderms, so I'm going to just flip this guy over and have a look and see if he has any parasites of interest. There's a couple we'd be interested in, but particularly a group of snails called eulimids that specialise on echinoderms. Let's see what he's got. Uh-oh.
He's chunky.
He is a chunky monkey.
Chunky boy.
He's a chunky boy. Lucky for, yeah, that's good. We can flip him back over.
Come on, little buddy. Put your bed.
Beautiful.
That looks like snake skin.
Yeah.
Doesn't it?
Yeah, alligator boots.
Get it. Get it. interested in contemplating.
See the lasers? Horse!
Oh,
make me see horses!
Oh, look at that! Woohoo!
Messages. Good job, guys.
There's another one. There's another one.
Yeah, there's
one
like
on
three
the three
of them.
Yeah, there's
yeah.
like... Yeah, up there. Check it closer.
I'm gonna get closer to get a better picture of them. There's quite a few of them.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five.
I think you can see sometimes like a shape and there's one on the other side.
Yeah.
Touch it.
Might be a
blue black.
Yeah.
Have we lost the scale bar on the image? I'm trying to work out how big he is.
What, the laser?
Oh, he's tiny.
Yeah, the laser. I mean, yeah.
That's, I'm zoomed all the way in.
Yeah, so the 10 centimeters is
like this big.
Yeah.
So if you look at the bottom, watch the bottom.
Oh, there it is. There, right? 10 centimeters.
So I'm going to put one of the lasers right next to him. Just
yeah,
so you can get an idea.
Really,
yeah,
so it's about a centimeter.
Baby hop with it.
Emma says hello.
So well camouflaged, aren't they?
They are.
Yeah, they change their colors as per the coral layer.
It's about a meter-ish across, judging by this.
There's like four of them.
No, I saw the three white spots. I haven't seen that third spot.
You go from top down to the left.
sea fan have any different characteristics from
the shallow beds, screen there.
You see these sea fans in shallow waters
so
as well.
There.
So,
yeah.
Yeah, often different species.
But we never actually zoomed in, it just looked like
fairly similar. They grow really tall.
Yeah.
You know, some of them can be, I think we worked out this one was probably about a meter or so across. That's quite a big one.
Oh, there. Up there.
But these sea fans are really characteristic. It's sort of 80 or 100 meters
long.
How long
is it going to go
around the northwest shelf? We see them a lot.
Oh, cool.
So this is really special just to be able to get so close to it.
Yeah.
I mean, normally we'd see it at sort
that
of
distance.
This distance where we know it's a sea fan.
Gotta go that way
anyway.
That's
what we can tell from it. So be able to zoom in like that and see the critters
that
come on it is just amazing.
Oh, they want to come to the beginning.
Bars.
Wow, great lens. Such a giant
chalice.
Going to white balance
now? Yeah. So it'll be soft or hard?
It's
a little bit rubbery, I suppose.
Okay.
Yeah. So I mean, you can tell it's got a fairly solid structure that stays
incredible.
In shape. But it is a sponge, so it's a bit squidgy.
I want to make that
hold up
a
little
bit.
Still see red?
Do you know what the perks that are growing in that shape is? Like, does it catch things up? Such an interesting shape.
Yeah, I mean, sponges take on all sorts of different shapes. And they don't, they feed by filtering water, basically. So it's not designed to necessarily capture food. I'm not really sure about the different reasons they form different shapes. I'm sure it's partly to do with the environment that they live in.
Because they're capturing light, I guess, also.
They do have symbiotic bacteria and things that live in them, but different to the corals in terms of capturing light. I'm talking here with our artist in residence, which is why she's asking all these difficult questions of me, because she's not one of the scientists on board and she's looking at things with a really different perspective. Ellie, do you want to tell everyone what you're doing here on board and your first impressions of our first dive at Ashmore Reef?
Hi everyone, it's a pleasure to be here with this amazing team that are just kind of reigniting my passion for the ocean. I'm here to kind of use my own way of creating stories to create some visual narratives of what we're discovering on this trip. So far it's been a beautiful time getting to know everyone and just kind of seeing how passionate everyone here is about what they do is really exciting. Today's been amazing. The 100 and 150 meters have kind of been the standout depths with so many beautiful patterns. I've been loving. I've been drawing non-stop pretty much since we started the dive in the library and capturing some images that I'll kind of turn later into some paintings. Yeah. If you have any questions, shoot them at me.
Thanks, Ellie. It is really great to have the artists on board because, you just give us such a different perspective of things that we get almost a little complacent about because we see them all the time and we think, yeah, there's another sponge.
Why is it that shape? What's the purpose of this?
All right, that's us at 100 meters.
Oh, we're beginning at the beginning of the transect. Oh, okay. So, Nerida, what was it we wanted to talk about at 100 meters? The transect. We're here. It was just
dead. It was basically where I was going is that when we were transiting between the end of the 150 and the start of the 100, there were these little corals and I thought they were interesting.
Are they cup corals or?
No, the kind of all sort of like lime color, yellowy green, sort of lime color stuff.
Right.
Okay.
Go north.
So maybe if we.
You said 150?
End of
150?
Yeah, so the end of 150 is a line, direct line between here and here.
Okay.
Oh, that was the other end.
That's the other end.
So we did 150
and up. Y'all don't want to go to this point
of interest. If we can just sort of start heading in the direction of the end of the 150 transect from here, then hopefully we'll be in the right area for them.
Well, no, going deeper to 150.
Okay. And you don't want to go to this point of interest?
I don't know what that was.
Oh, that was one of the bar zones.
Okay, that's been dealt with.
Thank you for reminding us.
So, are you going
south?
Are you going straight south?
Yep, to end of 150.
Oh, no, no, we just
left. Alright, Eric, we're going to keep moving south.
Good afternoon, J-Rod.
Oh,
going south.
Okay. Roger that, I'll give you another waypoint.
Hi, Jason.
Thank you.
That's nice. Beach to the sports side. Practicing his singing.
Yeah, I can get the other one.
He's getting his captain voice. I'm gonna cruise slow at this depth right here until the ship starts moving.
Good if we just like zigzag around as we go down or while we wait for the vessel.
Yep.
Yeah.
That would be fine.
Do that or we just stop.
Yeah, I mean it's good to just have a bit more of a detailed look around here now that we've finished the transects and we've got a bit of flexibility.
Snakeish.
Oh, I get
it. Looks like it could possibly do some harm to me.
Sorry, what was that question?
It said it looks like it could possibly do some harm to me. It looks like a snake.
Yeah. You were in
Australia. You are in Australia, after all.
Yeah, good point. As I keep saying, I don't know why people think Australia is dangerous. You guys have to deal with bears.
True.
We got nothing that scary here.
Bobcats. Cougars.
Drop bears.
Yeah, y'all have drop bears.
Yeah.
Big old.
Is one only open?
Want to take a better look at one of those?
Yeah, let's have a look.
It does look like banana peel. It's about done.
That's a great description.
Watch your steps.
A banana peel.
Yeah. You can always check every sea stones.
You want to tip him over?
Well, no, sometimes they just on the top.
Jeremy's asking about the whip bundle. Too late, Jeremy.
Maybe Jeremy can tell us what that whip bundle was.
He has little feet.
Yeah, you can see that.
Must spend a lot for shoes. Just saying. Sponsored by Nike. Cool man's cruise on.
Oh, hi.
suction cups. Slow down, don't know if it's feeling it.
So we're just trying to get a close-up look at this coral here. We think it might be an Antipodes dichotoma, which means it could be a really exciting find. And so we're just going to try and position ourselves to get a closer look and see if we can work it out. And if it is, we might try and collect a sample of it. Yep, we've got two more glorious weeks of this trip out here at Ashmore Reef, and we're going to be streaming our dives every day. So if you're enjoying this one, we've got lots more fun lined up for you. Looks like Jeremy's happy.
Want to see the base of it? Sure.
I'm sure.
I'm sure he wants it. Mr. Horowitz. Hey, buddy.
Yeah. Can't see much of this.
Bit too overgrown by the looks of it.
Yep. Oh, sorry.
We're good right here. Thank you.
Anna, do you want me to start doing sample searching?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, so I
want a sample of this?
Yes,
yeah,
please.
We'll just zoom out a bit and get a full kind of,
how much of it?
Beauty shot, the whole thing.
What's that, the whole thing?
Yeah. Definitely.
No, I mean,
get
a sample of it.
Oh. Mm,
you know,
yeah.
German.
Yeah.
How much did you say?
He looks big. Oh, come.
Got a good image of that, though?
Yeah,
yes.
I got one as well.
Thank you.
Yeah. But let's.
Yeah.
Enough to go into her quiver?
It's too big for a quiver.
Oh,
I
no,
guess the thing is,
I can cut off a piece of it, or
it'd be nice to know if the polyps at the base are different and important. Okay, maybe Jeremy will let us know.
I think he's still just excited we've even found it.
Yeah.
Screaming.
Do we need the base of this, Jeremy? Do we need the whole thing, or do we need part of it?
Cutting
okay.
a branch will be all right. That'd be great.
Done. Deal.
I reckon. Try and cut it somewhere up here. And then we can leave this bit behind.
Yeah. Twenty-three and 24 are the only ones that have stuff in them.
22 here,
yeah.
If you could, so that we've kind of got that whole cluster. We're not very demanding, are we? Beautiful.
Tissue off that skeleton pretty easily, so if it's going to cram in, I think.
It's bendy though, right?
Bendy but fragile. I'm going to say biobox. I worry about the tissue sloughing off.
Jeremy's happy. It'll fit in one of the smaller bio boxes. Beautifully done.
I think people are doing different things, but as long as whatever you call it, it's okay.
Sure.
Happy having Jeremy. Happy.
Till the next one.
He still owes us for past cruises.
For what?
The past cruise that we had.
Yeah.
You tell him.
Telecommunication.
Yeah, he's
tell
listening.
Him.
You tell him.
Oh,
what
he
does
knows.
He owe us? What do you reckon, Cody?
He knows. He knows what he owes. I'm Mr. Horowitz. You owe Team Texas.
Great decision.
Who? Oh, yeah. Am I still like
that? You're right. Let's go find some other corals.
Yeah.
And a big nudibranch.
Still need to find those corals that we actually came down here to look for.
Yeah.
Make sure the
pencil is disengaged. Roger. Will do. You know when?
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
that's
clear.
Hey, J-Rod. Go ahead.
Pitch will disengage and Milko's just going a little bit to starboard.
So neon green,
not neon, a bit more pastel.
More pastel.
We saw them over a pretty extended area when we were in that direct line between those two, and I suspect kind of a little maybe near that relief, like closer to 2/3 up.
Okay.
Oh.
Just yell at me.
Yeah.
You know the drill.
I got my pointer stick ready.
I was gonna say, boop, boop. Hit me with it.
Just a boop.
Just a boop. Jeremy, you said that last time, buddy. Me and J-Rod are keeping count.
What is this green stuff?
Yeah, I was going to say, I think we need to be probably a little closer to the bottom to see them.
Can we... And can we also have a look at that green stuff? Just wondering if it's halomela. Definitely not halomela. Is that what you thought you saw, Narada?
They weren't as big and branching as that. No,
it's a sponge.
Yeah. They were just like single fingers.
It's cute.
It's really like a cactus.
But similar color.
It is like a cactus, isn't it?
Super similar color.
Okay. Be on the lookout.
So they may have been just younger ones, but we'll see.
Yeah, because there was...
they definitely had that...
There's a couple of little ones down there, for example.
It was
Could
a,
that have been what we
It was a big
at?
Area and there were only just the little stubs, not colonies at all like that.
There's certainly quite a bit of that sponge here, isn't there?
Mm-hmm. The only thing that's raised in the red flag. is quite a bit. They're all big colonies.
Look at them all.
Yeah, they're all big colonies.
We need a sponge person to tell us if we know what it is.
Mm-hmm. Are you interested in that one that comes before us?
Gentlemen, do you reckon we could settle down somewhere and maybe have a little bit of a snooping around some of these rocks?
Find an interesting one?
Yeah, I think they'll all be interesting when we get up close to them.
Can I look this one right in front of us?
That one in front of us looks good, actually. They let the scientist in charge of the camera.
I reckon that's what I saw. It was more like this, but just single, like that.
Yeah, okay, so it is a sponge. It's a pretty cute sponge, though.
These ones don't have the ossicles on the end.
Maybe it's the angle that we're looking at them. Because if you look over here on this one, it, oops. No, it does on the end of that one.
Oh, yeah.
See?
Yeah. Because we were moving, it might have just not been very visible.
Yeah, I think it's just the angle that you're looking at them. I'll eventually work out how to use this joystick.
I never did.
Let's have a zoom in.
So I checked for leaks in the cabinet too.
It's like,
yeah.
Try to engage it what's on there.
Yeah.
Just stop. And then if you disengage it, then it kind of revs up and comes up, and then it'll kind of start doing its thing and then re-engage it. That's like a block. What's that?
That's like a block.
Now, there was a question there of what are the white critters on the sponge, and yeah, we think they're ascidians. Oh, speaking of ascidians. Oops, wrong way. Oh, that's a kitty.
Is that a mushroom?
It's a magic mushroom. Let's see what's growing on this softy.
You're just like, I need to look over there.
Someone keeps moving the submersible.
Down.
Yeah, thanks, guys. I have enough trouble getting this camera to go where I want it to go as it is without the ROV moving at the same time.
You want to zoom out a little bit? I'm going to get a better position for you. So you can go get more. That one over there?
No.
Okay.
I'm hoping the coral person will have a look.
Happy? That way. Now, what did you want me to look at there? Oh, the pink thing up there.
Yes.
Oh, guy.
Also, this stacked up halt is weird.
It's very pink.
That's definitely cut to the left.
Yeah. Oh, beautiful. I'm zoomed in as far as I can go. And there's another one up there, different one, different species.
Could be another one.
It's a shame we don't want to do population genetics on this green sponge. Oh, is that a narrator thing there? No.
No,
it's just the.
What is that? Shark to your right. Big shark. Big shark just came in.
Oh, yeah, I see it.
He came in from the right over here and brushed against us. Bacon.
You want to come straight onto it?
Just to be able to see it.
I think she wants to see it come on.
So that right there, you got right here.
Just having a closer look at this critter here because we're trying to work out what it is.
Do you want to try and get any of the corals at the same time? Because they could go in the same jar.
if you want to.
Do you think it's suction them up?
Yeah. Oh, that's exactly how you use it. Knock them off and then they go flying up. Perfect. Where is he? There he is. No idea what it is. I reckon there'll be a few in grabbing distance, I reckon. This suction does have a certain reach, but...
Such
I do, yeah. I want to give that a permanently collected boop. Does look like a bird actually.
Yeah, now that it's on its side.
Oh, there it goes. Well done. I'll wait till you see it in the jar. Many a thing has been lost between going in and never coming there. And yet it is also not there.
It's magic.
Stuff's common.
Sand.
We'll find out at the end of the day.
When the stuff's nice, we'll show you there.
So do you want to try and get a cup of water before they put it back, or no?
Something else y'all want here?
No, I think we'll just keep looking around.
Okay.
Keep going back down to 150.
Well, we've solved the what was the green
yeah,
coral, which, and see what takes Nerida's fancy.
So I think our final thought later on.
Look, like I have enough trouble telling left from right as it is. Oh, there we go. A hydrocoral. I'm used to seeing these in cold waters, not waters. That one's for Narissa if she's watching. Zoomed in as far as we can go, I'm sorry. What were you hoping of? So colourful, isn't it? Excellent. It's just so- clinging onto the coral. How cute. Yeah, it's an octocoral. It's got a little brittle star living on it with its arms entwined around the branches. Yes, a couple of them by the looks of it. Alrighty. Nothing you have to have?
No.
Okay.
Ready?
Let's move on. Let's see what else we can find.
Bunny hop.
I'm going to hop, say, 10 meters down.
Yeah, that sounds perfect. Thanks.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Oh, let's zoom on the fish.
I'm gonna pretend this isn't happening.
Can you tell us what that is?
Like a tiger fish.
Yeah.
Gratuitous.
Now that they automatically take every 5 seconds. I know what this
Sure, it's convinced about us, yeah?
Wow.
No hope.
Yeah, not bad for something that's not a coral. Oh, it's beautiful. Colours.
It looks very soft.
I suspect it's very pretty.
I think it's very, yeah. I think it's got quite a hard test, but the spines are neat. Yeah, see, there's a I wouldn't mind flipping it to see if it does parasite.
You want to flip it?
Oh.
Oh, hey, look at that little coral there. Sorry. Yeah, if we could flip that. Just changing shift here.
Those snakes.
They surely are.
Are there at least from Australia?
Yeah, they're in the
Kimberley,
I think it's all.
Is
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Really dying.
Pardon? We'd like to flip this guy.
We could have a look, see if he's got any parasites under.
No problem.
Plus, I'm going to flip this over. Let's have a look at him. I think we might collect him actually while we're here.
Yeah.
Once you see the second one, you start to think that's something interesting.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We're going to flip and do.
Okay.
So, yeah, there'll be shots of him, I guess.
In front of it.
Oh, look at it. Oh.
He may have actually helped us. Wow, it can certainly put on a bit of speed when it puts its mind to it.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You.
Certainly realise how dark it is once you turn away from the light.
Yeah, okay.
It is late in the afternoon. It's gonna start running in the opposite direction.
Yeah, it is.
We shouldn't laugh, should we?
It's quick,
dude. It's amazingly quick.
Quick.
Yeah.
Left or right?
Or just gonna move him over more slowly.
I think this is called confuse a cat.
He's so fast. Wow.
My goodness, that speed.
He's using gravity now, but
he might, yeah, it might flip himself over for you if you like.
He's understanding the situation.
Well,
now he's going to ride himself quickly, so let's have a zoom in. Okay, I didn't see any evidence of anything, so I think it's okay. I think he's clear.
Although now there is actually a pink coral just up on the left. There he is. There.
Gotcha.
Wouldn't mind having a good look at that and probably collecting it as well.
So it's down, sort of just down here.
Yeah, it's a little solitary coral.
Not that one.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
No, 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 sorry, not the,
sorry.
Not the, not
this,
the,
this
there he is, that guy.
Not the big, pretty one, that's
what
I was getting.
What do you mean, not the big, pretty one?
It's
what
a small,
about?
Pretty one.
It's beautiful.
A closer look, because I didn't look for it.
Maybe a little bit closer.
Okay, I like
a little. Okay, sorry.
That's right.
No sign of that urchin. He's long gone.
He has, isn't he? He's
yeah.
Skedaddle.
I mean, yeah, I had a field of view entirely.
No, I'm gonna move over.
Although there's probably like a few.
Oh, that's good. We are very precariously perched here, so it's going to move around a little bit unless I get a little bit.
Okay.
You've lost this. Get a
I keep seeing lots of pink things now.
Yeah, I know. It's a really specific kind of fuchsia color, isn't it?
What's that?
Try a little like that, you think we'll touch that rock.
Yeah, now we're above it. Alright. Do you want to look at it or just take it?
I think we've looked at it enough, so yeah, if you want to grab that probably with the suction sample.
Okay.
Best option.
Might
need to nudge it a bit. Challenge is actually quite well stuck, isn't it?
Yeah, it's definitely not.
It doesn't want to give up its love for science. Yep, in the jar.
Yeah, you see. See how you can really see it.
Yeah. No, I don't think so at this stage. Let's just keep having a bit of a look around.
Want to take control of the camera?
I can do that.
All right, it's all you. Let's see, we've been up north, so we can go east. We're good.
It's that orange and stuff over there. Oops, that way. Stuff.
Are you expecting to see some encrusted corals here?
I'm surprised we haven't seen a few, but I guess it...
to the right would be better for the lighting.
That's towards that way, isn't it?
There you go.
Yeah, 100 metres is probably pretty much the maximum limit we'd see any of the encrusting corals. We usually start to peter at around 70, 80 metres.
Do you think deeper down, deep more stuff like that?
Oh, no.
Do you continue to move down?
I'm moving east, southeast, yeah.
Bridge, RV, I've just moved your waypoint, you said.
Copy that, Rush, can you tell?
We're at 125 meters.
Mm. And you're interested in cup corals?
Cool. What's that? Aha, that's our pink friend. Shall we have a go with him?
And there's, is it a different one too?
Yeah, that one's a different species.
What that?
Yeah, please.
Okay.
If you can,
go.
Yeah, right at the bottom of the screen. Get like one of those, that bit or something. I suspect we should go with the suction sampler again.
Okay.
Do you reckon?
I don't know.
Or do you want to try it with the arm?
Maybe with the arm.
I mean, it was pretty hard to get off last
time.
You
look at the suction sampler, the smaller holes in the center, that's actually the largest.
Yeah.
I think that would be too large.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try it with the arm and see how we go.
Okay. It's a little white thing up here I just want to look at some point.
Okay, we'll do that after.
It's a long shell. No, it was we were going to put the black coral in there, but we. I reckon
it's about that wide, I would say. So it'll be. It'll go in by.
Most of it will go in.
I reckon it'll crumble into multiple parts when you try and pick it up.
Yeah, I guess. So we'll get something that will fit in a quiver. And we should probably at some point get those tiny little loops. That are so cute.
Do you want to just take a small piece?
Yeah, just take that. That'll be fine if you can pick it up.
Right.
Yeah, I'm just reading back to you.
Yeah, you see, that's a perfect size for that sliver. That's all you got.
Yep.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. Woohoo.
Now, where was that thing you wanted to check in? Now, there's something just up on the left side that Nerida wanted to have a look at.
It's that white thing, I just want to have a little peep at it.
Oh, that little thing.
Yeah. Shines like a mollusk. Probably isn't. No. Cool.
You good?
Yeah, good, thank
okay.
you.
I'll text you. I'm going to play around a little bit to get parts.
Okay.
Oh, okay.